evening.
And welcome to the Glencorp School of Music here at the University of Nebraska. My name is Chris Varga, and I'm here to present my final DMA jazz composition recital. Welcome. Thank you for coming. I'm pleasantly surprised that there's so many people here. I'm just going to step out of it right there. Everybody hear me okay?
Yeah. Can't see you.
All right. Perfect. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about what we're going to play tonight. There's a little bit of information in the program notes. As it says, these are a few Hungarian folk songs that I somewhat arbitrarily picked out of a collection of about 12. My choices for these three songs were based on mainly one thing, that I just like the songs. Secondly, I tried to pick stuff that would be better suited towards instruments playing the melody. Since the original ones are vocal melodies, and they're folk musicians, amateur musicians, there's a lot of things kind of going in and out of tunes, things that sound funky to our Western ears, perhaps. A lot of smearing or altering of the pitches in other ways. So, also, everything is out, pretty much out of rhythm, and mostly solo, so there's no need for things to be in rhythm if they choose to do so. So, unfortunately, we can't just play out of time for 30 to 40 minutes. Well, we could, I guess. But that might get boring. So, one challenge was to try to put these things that are out of time into a specific meter or a specific time signature or rhythm. Some things that you will hear are actually close to the original, in that there is some rubato or things that are out of tempo and played in a more free manner. Yeah, so that actually was the hardest part, was one, transcribing the melodies and putting them into a particular scale or mode, and then also putting things into a specific rhythm. Even when I did put it into a specific time signature or pattern, I tried to, as best as I could, to retain the general pacing of the original melody, which was originally out of time. Of the three tunes, perhaps the second one, the middle tune, is something closest to what the original would sound like in terms of being out of tempo. In the first movement, or the first part, the original melody is most altered or changed to the point that it would be pretty much unrecognizable. But again, as I say in the program notes, I try to retain kind of the original flavor or character of each one. We're going to play all three pieces back to back. Feel free to applaud anytime, but hopefully after a piece is finished, that'd be good. We'll feel a little better about that. Or any other time you feel like applauding, please do after a solo, perhaps. So I'm getting all the talking out of the way now, so that we can kind of do that. A few other things. I really need to thank quite a few people, so please bear with me on this. First of all, my supervisory committee, my faculty committee, Tom Larson, Hans Sturm, Scott Anderson, and Hendrik Vandenberg. Of course, the UNL family knows that's not the whole story. Dr. Eric Richards, who recently left to take a position at another school, was my teacher for the entire 3 years, the previous 3 years, and none of this would be possible without him, of course. He was quite the role model, not just musically, but professionally and personally as well. I'd also like to thank Drs. Paul Haar, our Director of Jazz Studies here at UNL, Dr. Daryl White, Dr. Dave Hall, and Dr. Peter Buffard. I was lucky enough to play in the faculty jazz ensemble off and on, and playing with those gentlemen was quite a treat over the last 3 years. I'd also like to thank Dr. Tony Bushard and Dr. Peter Lefferts for their help along the way. Almost last, certainly not least, I'd like to thank Dr. Masayoshi Ishikawa, not only for conducting today, but being a good friend the last few years and kind of, you know, being a partner in crime here during the studies. And finally, and certainly not least at all, a personal note to my brother Jason Varga and his wife Neum. Definitely none of this would have been possible without them during the last 3 years, both emotional, moral, and practical support as well. So Jason's here somewhere, isn't he? Where is he? There he is. Okay. Thank you. Okay. And if I may, I'd like to introduce this great band we have. In the string section, it's Carla Baxter on viola. She's playing violin. On viola, Lexi Raygor, and on cello, Molly Rezich. We're temporarily out of order for the positioning of the first piece, so I'll just go from this side to that side. On bass trombone, Amber Thoennes. On bari and bass clarinet, Patrick Brown. On tenor and clarinet, Mr. Andrew Janak. On soprano and flute, Mike Lee. On trumpet and flugel, J.C. McBee. Also on trumpet and flugel, Mr. Russell Zimmer. And in the rhythm section, on guitar, Lee Heerspink. We have a couple semi-special guests in the back here. All the way from Chicago, Illinois. On drums, Matt Carroll, and on bass, Mr. Clark Sommers. Thank you so much again for coming, and we hope you enjoy the music. Thanks. Thank you.
room